you know that phrase, if society has an itch, schools get scratched. So there tends to be whatever the problem is in society, we get them to do something in schools about it. Communities and societies are going through rapid change. We can't expect schools to fix it, but are schools keeping up?
We are facing a huge problem of a growing social divide in Northern Ireland, and we're not paying enough attention to it. The structure of our system reinforces that. It reinforces that division. It was exacerbated by the experience of COVID, and currently we're facing a whole raft of cuts to programmes, which are also further exacerbating this. It's putting officials in the department in an impossible position. But it's linked to a wider set of activities because we have some, there's been a lot of very good regeneration activity, but what that is doing, it's worthwhile and it's good, but it's producing, it's bringing in inward investment, producing lots of high quality jobs for graduates. But communities that don't have that, those opportunities are being left behind. They're being planned out of the process. Inner city communities are being cut off from these opportunities. These regeneration programs aren't connected to an anti-poverty strategy. They're not providing opportunities using things like social enterprise. So we're facing this growing social divide, and I don't see any sense among the politicians that it's been taken seriously.
I think visually as a country, we have changed in terms of our diversity. It has grown so much over the course of the years. But unfortunately, I think in terms of our curriculum and keeping up with the changes that have occurred in terms of our population, unfortunately, they are still lagging behind. Our curriculums have not changed very much in the last 30 years. And I don't believe that they're reflective of our current population of Ireland.
If you're from a minority group and you're put down so much in life and you face high levels of race and discrimination, you feel isolated and excluded, it's not easy to go on. We have 13% of travellers who complete secondary education compared to the comparison like to 92% of the general population. I know going forward as a traveller mother that education is vital important. It's the only way you're going to get in life. If you don't try and fight towards them barriers, trying to break them barriers down yourself, then you're not going to get somewhere.
We often think that education has got to do with content, we think that it has to do with opportunity and future career prospects, but I think one of the most important things for education is that those who are involved in it should give and share hope to one another. And that's where I think teacher and pupil come together and where the pupil can actually influence the community and the home.
Substantial pockets of Northern Ireland were probably those areas that have been most impacted, directly impacted by the conflict. You know, mentioned the impact of the ongoing thriving paramilitarism and criminality that there is in Northern Ireland, and the ecosystem that allows that to continue to be viable. And I know in the Fresh Start Agreement there were serious plans, holistic plans to address that, and obviously not having a government just puts that further down the line, and that creates the vacuum and those groups become more powerful. If we're really interested in equality of opportunity in Northern Ireland, you know, I'm just speaking to that frame, we can't continue to just have an acceptable level of avoidance and invisibility around these issues.
I just did my Leaving Cert last year, and what education was for and what was grilled into us was the pressure of education is for the exam, education is for going to college, is for the Leaving Cert. It's to progress to further in life, and that ultimately led to my value as a human being, which was the CEO points.
If we're going to have a system for children in Northern Ireland and Ireland that works, then it needs to be integrated. We can't just pretend that we're all the same and just have two separate systems, all differently segregated on the basis of ability, of class, of whether or not you're a Catholic or you're a Protestant, whether you speak Irish or whether you don't. We need to have schools that work for everyone, where we bring children together of all different backgrounds, ability, class, whether they are Catholic, Protestant or neither.
We're in the middle of a 50-year plus peace process. Made great advances in the first 25 years of that process, but the next 25 years is critical. That's when we really need to get into the acts of ending segregation in the north around housing, around peace barriers, and especially around education, to get our young people and children in the same classrooms every day together, building relationships, building knowledge of each other.
Ireland ratified the UN Convention on the Rights of the Child, and I'd like us to apply the provisions of that convention in the same way as a couple of years ago. Everything we did we had to apply a COVID lens to it. Can we do that for education about children?
Very much in line with the Catholic ethos. We think special education is certainly one of those areas that needs to be prioritised. We are one of the only non-state patron actors in the special education sector in terms of special ed schools. A lot of our schools, needless to say, deal with ASD classes and special ed provision of schools. While there has been an increase in the number of teachers and SNAs for these education needs, we've seen a fall off in the supports that are very necessary to allow children to flourish properly to the full extent of their capacities, such as occupational therapists, speech and language therapists and physiotherapists. And certainly this is something that urgently needs to be addressed if we are truly going to have a shared island where all peoples from all different backgrounds can actually flourish to the best of their ability.
I think we're in danger, certainly in the north, of not giving children an education, but giving them a set of qualifications. We're very soon going to have the ability that AI will be able to answer the questions. Give us the formula. Do the work for us. So how will humans be judged?
Policy has its benefits, but we must realise the frailty of policy and the centrality of legislation. See if I could take one policy that we need to implement, a policy that allows for the transition of students across the continuum of education from primary to secondary to higher education that is not only based on a numerical conjecture of quality or indeed intergenerational privilege.
In terms of a dialogue, one of the things that becomes really clear about education is that there can be a tendency for those of us south of the border to think we know, and actually we know and understand very little.
New communities are springing up all over our country, north and south. We were 65,000 new people from Ukraine and international protection applicants in the south alone. They need to be integrated. In Drogheda, new communities are led by Hands for Unity, which is a group of people who are new into our society, are working, meeting all the state agencies and the voluntary bodies, having days like Africa Day, having inclusive social events. Making a big change needs to happen everywhere.
More sharing and cooperation north and south, but some specific issues within the northern education system, and particularly around academic selection and really the fractures that causes and some of the social division that it is creating as well, and the inequalities that it's perpetuating.
We have to accept religion. It's who we are. It's part of people's identity. That has to be embraced. So I think what we have to do if we're moving forward to our education system is to embrace the difference. That is true diversity.
We need an education system that is combined with an anti-poverty system to ensure that all children are included and to ensure we have equity in our education system. The cost of not investing in our education system must be measured. It's not about cost, it's about investing. We must invest in our education system. I think we have a real opportunity here to create a conversation about what are the values that should underpin our education system across the island. We have an opportunity, let's not lose it.
It's been so interesting hearing the different areas of educational policy and how it affects people north and south of this island. Key themes today have been around equity over quality and inclusion rather than integration, and I think we all have a lot to learn and think about leaving today.